Hey, Internet. This is Perry reporting for TSG, my fourth time back in Montreal for a super sweaty, greasy day. Yeah. So please excuse my greasy face. I don't know. I decided to do this video with my hat off because I always wear a hat. And I'll at least keep my hat off for part of the video.
Okay, if I scruff it around a little.
Yeah, you can scruff it.
Ooh.
Clearly I'm hanging out with Morgan C on the same couch that she recorded her video on earlier this week. Except this time before we sat down, there was pee all over it.
Yeah.
Cat pee. We had to wipe it off.
I'm house sitting for my friend and I'm supposed to clean the litter box, but I didn't do it. And out of protest, our sassy lady cat has peed all over the couch.
Yeah.
I'll bring her over. You can see what a princess she is.
June has a little mace too, I'm pretty jealous. So yeah, I came over to talk to Morgan because I was like, I need some inspiration for my video because I feel like I got really overwhelmed and I was like, there are so many different letters I could write about my gender, and some of them are happy and some of them are angry and some of them are love letters and some of them have a lot of demands involved. So I was like, maybe in my video I should talk about how instead of writing, like, a single letter to my gender, I would have to actually start, like, a reading and writing group where all my genders could, like, come together every other week with, like, a writing assignment they've done and put it in a pile, and then another person, well, another part of my gender could come and, like, pick it out of the pile and respond to it. And so it'd be, like, this ongoing process where my genders just process each other and themselves.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah, it's pretty complicated, but...
What's, like, an example of a love letter that you would write?
A love letter? It'd be like, dear gender. Probably in cursive, really, like, bubbly cursive.
Yeah.
And it'd be like, dear gender, I really like your fake eyelashes and your sparkly pink eyeliner and the colors you wear. Love, Perry. Love. There's a little hard.
Yeah. What about demands? What kind of
demands?
Strongly worded demands.
Strongly worded? It'd probably be the shortest letter of them all. And it'd be like, dear gender. But like all erratic font, like, dear gender, show yourself, Perry. A period at the end of my name.
So stop eating my food in the fridge.
Yeah.
I know it was you.
That'd be my passive aggressive letter to the gender. The facets of my gender, I don't want to admit or that. Like, dear gender, can you stop leaving your toenail clippings on the bathroom floor? Sincerely, Perry. Dear gender, why did you quit your job? Now you can't pay rent. Perry.
Oh, gender.
Gender.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
I don't know
what else either.
I guess next week, you're going to be on the road again.
I'll be in Halifax next week. I think. I might not end up going because, like, my travel buddy, last minute, might want to stay longer than me.
Oh, I see.
And I really want to be back for the queer zine fair that we're tabling at together. So if you're, like, queer trans and want to put some zines on our table, we're not going to charge you. But, like, get in touch with one of us.
Yeah, I guess so.
And we'll
manage that.
Jam you on our table. Yeah.
Scenes.
August 18th.
Oh, my
Montreal.
Yeah.
We'll be fine.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
Okay, well,
we'll see
you back next week.
There's no bonus questions. That's it. Yeah, I'll be back next Saturday. Morgan will be back Tuesday. Wednesday?
I don't know. I'm leaving Wednesday.
There's a day.
Get back Saturday.
Morgan's making video for it.
Oh, yeah, Tuesday. I'll see you on Tuesday.
Bye.
Goodbye, Internet.